While we love the Loud House, sometimes we can't help but wonder what might happen if things were a little bit different. Some fans of the show have as well, and that's why today we're going to tell you about 10 The Loud House fan fiction stories that are better than the original. Be sure to stay to the end to find a bit of work that contains something for everyone. If this is your first time visiting the things, then make sure to give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Today we're going to show you the 10 The Loud House fan fiction stories that are better than the original. 1. Turkey at the Loud House. For a show which is fast becoming very much an American tradition, there's something missing from the world of the Loud House. That would be a Thanksgiving special. So that's why we should all be rather thankful to Loud House fan Jokeman20. He noticed the problem, and he would decide to do something to fix the problem. He wrote 1 Turkey Over the Loud House, which tells the tale of the Loud family experiencing their own difficulties dealing with the annual November festivities. In it, the family is about to sit down to their Thanksgiving dinner. And poor Lincoln, as ever, finds himself with perhaps the toughest task of all, sorting out the sitting arrangements. Working out who to put next to who is a bit of a challenge, but he manages to solve it. Because Lori and Leni are always arguing, for instance, they can't sit next to each other. Then he meets with his sisters to work out which dessert they'd like to have after their turkey. Of course, no one can agree on anything, but fortunately, Lynn Sr., their father, has a pretty smart solution. He decides that they should make all 3, and he can decide what's the best one. It's a very smart, funny story, and it certainly plugs a gap. If you thought the title was familiar, it's a tribute to the episode, One Flew Over the Loud House. Lincoln's birth. Something that quite a lot of fans of The Loud House wonder is what it was like for the Loud family in the time before the show aired. What were the Loud kids like when they were younger? Well, you might not have to wonder for much longer. That's because Loud House fan First Drell Specter has written their very own work of fan fiction, set back in the dark and mysterious days of 2005. That would be when Lincoln, who, let's face it, is pretty much the main character in the program, was born. And the story's subject and title is Lincoln's birth. In the story, there are much younger versions of Luna, Luan, Lori, Leni, Lynn Jr., Lynn Sr., and Rita Loud. By the way, have you ever wondered why Lynn Loud Sr. gave his daughter his name? A theory behind that is explained in this story, and it makes sense. We find out a lot more about the family, what they were expecting, and how they behaved in the years prior to the Loud House becoming packed full of kids. It's actually a pretty sweet, fun, and likable story. We even find out why it is Lincoln Loud is called Lincoln Loud, and it's really funny. So we think that if you're a fan of the Loud House who's interested in the backstory, you should check it out. 2nd Loud Brother. One of the many great things about fan fiction is that you can take the idea of a story, or a TV show, or a film, and then you find out what happens next. If you like it, then you can tell people about what you find. So fans of The Loud House have often speculated about what would happen if there were to be another addition to the Loud family. That's what fan First Drell Specter did, and they wrote about it and published it on the internet. In 2nd Loud Boy, we find out that Rita and Lynn Loud Sr. are expecting to have another baby. Of course, with this being the Loud House, nothing is ever entirely straightforward. But luckily, everything ends up pretty much resolved by the end, and we even see how Lucy and Lincoln make a pact. Now they are the two middle children. Anyway, the baby ends up being born, and it's a boy. So luckily for Lincoln, he isn't the only boy out of the Loud family children. And with the Louds being the way they are, the boy has a name beginning with the letter L. He's called Leopold. What a lovely name. You know, we can't help but wonder how Rita feels about being the only member of the family whose name doesn't begin with that particular letter. Run Inkin Away. Sometimes things can be tough for Lincoln Loud. It's going to be a bit tricky growing up in an environment where you're the only boy and you've got 10 sisters to deal with. That's a relatively common theme in the Loud House, and it's always dealt with in a way that's funny, warm-hearted, and endearing. That's why we're such huge fans of the program. But it is a theme that offers a lot of dramatic possibilities. That's why we think Loud House fan Harburton81 decided to write their own story that dealt with the matter, entitled Run Inkin Away. Now, the title of the story should give you some kind of idea as to what this particular work of fan fiction is all about. In case you hadn't guessed it, It's about Lincoln reaching the end of his tether with his sisters and running away from home. Pretty dramatic stuff, right? It turns out that in the story, Lincoln is fed up with the way he's being treated, so he leaves a long, detailed note and gets up and leaves. His sisters miss him, and using flashbacks to classic episodes of the show, they decide to go searching for him. He isn't in their hometown of Royal Woods anymore, but this is another really good story, and it could easily be made into an episode of the show. Real Boys. One of our favorite episodes of The Loud House ever is One of the Boys. It's an episode where Lincoln gets fed up with being the only boy surrounded by sisters and wonders what would happen if he were to be in a family full of boys. His sister Lisa gets wind of this idea of Lincoln's and decides to do what she can to make his dream a reality. So she builds him a watch, which can transport him into this alternative universe. However, there is one problem. That is, Lincoln has 24 hours to return to his normal life, or else he will be stuck in the parallel dimension forever. At the start, Lincoln really loves being in this new world. He and his brothers all go to Dairyland, and then they head to Gus's Games and Grub to eat some pizza. Lincoln is absolutely loving it here, so he decides to throw the watch away. However, things don't always go so swimmingly. His brothers are pretty mean to him, and he can't seem to get any sympathy from them, unlike the treatment he'd get from some of his sisters. So he ends up finding the watch in the nick of time and heading home. Now, fanfiction writer The 21st Century Pendragon decided to write about what would happen if Lincoln stayed in his all-boys household. It's pretty good, and it takes a classic episode in a new direction. What is human? One of the many things people who love The Loud House love about it is the sheer range of humanity on offer. Yes, we know that it's a cartoon, but there's something about the characters that feels very warm, human, and real. So we couldn't help but be interested in this next story. It was written by a fan fiction writer with the curious name of King Genocide. But that wasn't the only thing that made us intrigued about this particular piece of work. You see, it started with a pretty unusual premise. What if The Loud House only had female kids? What if there was no Lincoln Loud? Now, that might seem a bit unusual. After all, if there was going to be just one main character in The Loud House, you would probably say that it would be Lincoln. He's our entry point into the lives and adventures of the Loud family. But this story comes up with an ingenious premise. The idea is that there is no Lincoln, but there is a replacement for him. And that replacement is a robot. It's called Robot Link AR, and over the course of this epic story, we find out how the Loud family react to it, and how it reacts to them. We even discover a little bit about what it might mean to be human. Leni in The Loud House. Something that fanfiction can do, and often does very well, is to introduce new characters into the canon of a story, film, or TV show. What's especially good about this is that when something like that happens in the established stories, responses can be mixed. A lot of people still don't really like Scrappy-Doo from the Scooby-Doo franchise, and he's been around for a long, long time now. But if it's fan fiction, that doesn't really matter, because you usually just have the one story to deal with the new character. But where can you put a new member of the family in The Loud House? Fan fiction writer King Hammer Publishing had one idea. They decided that the latest character should be another sister, called Leni Loud. In their story, Leni is age 7, which puts her between Lana and Lucy. She's afraid of clowns, and she is kind and helpful towards her brother and her sisters. She has a fondness for art and is always expressing herself through painting. She has brown hair with a bang covering one of her eyes, and she wears a scarf, a black t-shirt, and a blue skirt. We think we like her, and we think it's interesting to see how she interacts with the more established characters. We reckon she'd be a cool character to have in an alternative universe-style episode. Linka and her brothers. If you're a fan of The Loud House like we are, then you'll know exactly what the premise of the show is. It's all about a boy called Lincoln Loud, who lives with his 10 sisters, who are called Lori, Leni, Luna, Luann, Lynn, Lucy, Lana, Lola, Lisa, and Lily Loud. They live with their parents, Lynn Sr. and Rita, in the town of Royal Woods, Michigan. So far, so good. But we wondered what would happen if the roles were reversed. There was one classic episode, called One of the Boys, where Lincoln Loud traveled into an alternative reality, where he had 10 brothers. However, in that episode, Lincoln was still a boy, he just didn't have any sisters. However, the premise of that episode was taken to the next level in one ingenious work of fan fiction. Writer Smoking Wrecker came up with the story, Linka and Her Brothers. In it, there is one girl, called Linka Loud, She has a number of brothers, which include Luke, Lane, Lars, Levi, Lynn, Loki, Lex, and Lonnie Loud. It seems like a simple idea, but it works really well, we think. We just like the idea of the world of the Loud House, which is one we think we know pretty well, being turned upside down. We think that it's similar enough to be familiar, but different enough to be interesting. Meeting Aloud. One of the key points in the Loud House is the importance of family. No matter how annoying they may get, the family is always there for Lincoln to give him support, advice, and love. But sometimes you do have to ask, what does family mean? And how do we get to know what is a family and what isn't? That is the idea that spurred the next piece of fan fiction into being. This is a story by author Zackler16, and it takes as its premise the idea that Lincoln Loud isn't just different from his sisters because he's a boy, but because he isn't a blood relative. This idea, that Lincoln was actually a foster child, is explored and developed inside this story. We like the idea, not least because it allows for a little bit of character development, and it gives us something different within the program's mythos. We see how Lynn Sr., for instance, interacts with his friends, which we don't think we see enough of in the show. We see a new, more vulnerable side to Lincoln, too, which is a refreshing difference. But what is really reassuring about this story is the way the sisters act. Even though it's a slightly different premise to the one we've got on the show, they still care for and support Lincoln in their own way. Lincoln and... Something that we absolutely love about the Loud House is the sheer number and variety of the characters. With Lincoln, his 10 sisters, their parents, and their friends, you're never going to find yourself getting bored with them. However, there is a flip side to this. That is, you might not quite see enough of one of your favorite characters. There's only so much time a character can spend on screen, and that means that you might go a while before spending time with someone who you really like. So that's why this particular work of fan fiction is so good. It's by a writer called Disc98, and it talks about the ways in which Lincoln interacts with every one of his 10 sisters. We see him get support from Lori, help Luan with her problems, receive an apology from Lynn Jr., look after Lisa, and much more. What we like about this collection of short pieces of fan fiction is that we get to spend a bit of time with all of the Loud sisters, but not so much that we want to move on and get to the next one straight away. But that makes us think of a couple of questions. Firstly, who is your favorite Loud sibling? Secondly, which Loud sibling are you most like? Don't be shy, let us know in the comments. And that's it for our 10 The Loud House fan fiction stories that are better than the original. If you liked it, then check out 10 Cartoon Secrets Finally Revealed. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe!